So here we are on the third problem of chapter 14 homework, and there are three kinds of tests that we're learning in this chapter with the chi-square distribution. The first kind is a goodness of fit test. We've already done a couple of those problems. Then the next kind is called a chi-square test for homogeneity. And this is when you take multiple samples, each of the same size, from different populations. So, for example, you have two branches of a bank, and you select 100 transactions from each bank. So 100, and then 100, then 200. Whenever your total sample consists of two separate samples coming from different places or different data sources, then it's a chi-square test for homogeneity. So we're trying to see if the distribution of ages is different or the same at the in-town branch versus the mall branch. So maybe, for example, people in the in-town branch might be younger or something like that. So anyway, our null hypothesis, of course, is that the distributions are the same, so everything is equal. The alternative would be that something is not equal, so something is different. This is a chi-square test of homogeneity. So a test for independence is when you have one large sample that involves all the different variables. So it's almost identical to the test for homogeneity. The independence and homogeneity work the same way. Everything is calculated the same way. The difference is how they begin. Test for independence has one large sample that just randomly falls across all the categories. The test for homogeneity, you have separate specific samples coming from each part of the data. Okay, so now here is when we're going to use this amazing website that I created exclusively only for my students in the whole world. So go to math111.com/chi.html. It's amazing. So then this is how you enter the data. So you can zoom in if you want. Perfect. Now, where did the problem go? So look at this data, and then let's just maybe like copy to clipboard. Okay. So that's fine. Now, in fact, actually, this is the data. It would be actually easier to just type the data in instead of copying it. Because if I copy it, it'll have all those words and things and the totals. All you need to type into my website is the numbers in the middle of the table. So 20 space 40 space 40, then a new line, 30 space 50 space 20. And then you're done. Click the button. Presto, it'll calculate the expected values automatically for you. It's the same exact way that we did it before, except I have to tell you how. I mean, sorry, the chi-square is calculated the same exact way as before, but I need to tell you how the expected values are calculated. For example, how does the 25 get there? So, see this number, in fact, let's pick a random number like 50. How do you calculate the expected value for 50? Well, I highlight the number 50, or I point to it with my finger, and then I total up the column that's vertically. So 40 plus 90. So what's 40 plus 90? Let me just open up a calculator real quick. So here I am on a calculator. And, sorry, 40 plus 50 is 90. 40 plus 50 is 90. Now, total up horizontally the row that 50 is in. So the row total is 30 plus 50 plus 20. Now, total up all of the numbers. So 20 plus 40 plus 40 plus 30 plus 50 plus 20. Now, what you do is you multiply the vertical number times the horizontal number of where 50 is. So vertically through 50 and then horizontally through 50. and divide that by the total of all the data. So, boom, then you get 45. So, see where I highlighted the 50? The 50 became 45 because if I use that 50, add up the vertical numbers that go through 50, the 40 and the 50, and then the horizontal numbers that go through 50, 30, 50, and 20. If I add up that column and that row and then multiply the totals together and divide by the grand total of all the data, then I get 45. So that's how that works. So presto. I can instantly enter this in. I'm going to scroll down. Oh, it won't scroll down because it's already as small as it can get. All right, so it'll be 25, 45, 30. The expected value is 25, 45, and 30. Perfect. Whoops. Check answer. Good job. Okay, but what's the chi-square statistic? You get that by calculating the expected values minus the observed, the observed minus the expected squared divided by the expected, and exactly the same way as we did on the first two problems of this chapter. And then you get this number right there when you add them all up. So that's the answer. Once again, my website will do that for you automatically. It's amazing and wonderful. How many degrees of freedom? Now, there's degrees of freedom horizontally and vertically, and you have to multiply them together to get the total degrees of freedom. So there's two rows, there's the two branches, and there's three age categories. So the branches actually have 2 minus 1 is 1 degree of freedom multiplied by horizontally, there are three categories of ages, so 3 minus 1 is 2, so there's 2 degrees of freedom, and of course, a rectangle, like, you multiply together, so 1 times 2 equals 2. So the formula is this. It's the number of rows minus 1 times the number of columns minus 1, which is 1 and 2, and 1 times 2 equals 2, so the answer is 2. Okay, now I found the critical value. So this critical value is on the chi-square calculator. And we have 2 degrees of freedom, presto. So we'll type in probability of 0.05 on the right side, and we get 5.99, etc. Boom. 0.991. Excellent. So what do we conclude? Our value is about 9.78, so test statistic is definitely greater than the critical value, so there is a lot of evidence, so there's sufficient evidence to reject the null. So the distribution of ages at the two branches is we conclude, is not the same. That doesn't prove it's not the same, it just means that we conclude that it's not the same.